If you're looking to build a commercial-grade deep net application, then DeepLearning4j is worth looking into. In addition to a big selection of deep nets, this Java library provides a lot of great tools, like a distributed multi-node map-reduce procedure and a package for vectorization. Let's dive in and take a closer look. DeepLearning4j is the brainchild of SkyMind's Adam Gibson. The library is also referred to as DL4j. DL4j is a commercial-grade deep learning library that can run on a distributed, multi-node setup. The J in DeepLearning4j stands for Java, which is the programming language the library is built upon. This particular library allows you to configure a deep net by selecting values for its hyperparameters. It comes with built-in GPU support for a distributed framework, which is an important feature for the training process. As an addition, the library can run on both Scala and Clojure. DL4j supports all of the deep nets we've seen up to this point, the RBM, DBN, Convolutional Net, Recurrent Net, RNTN, autoencoders, and even the vanilla MLP. DL4j also includes a vectorization library called Canova, which was built by the same team. Training any machine learning model on a distributed framework requires the use of a two-step procedure called Iterative Map-Reduce. In the map step, the input data is distributed across all the nodes in the cluster. Each node then trains the net with the portion of the data that it receives. In the reduce step, the weights and biases across every node in the cluster are averaged together. Each node replaces the parameters of its net with this new average. These two steps are repeated iteratively until the overall error is sufficiently small. This is how DL4j trains a model on a distributed platform. In contrast, a traditional map-reduce procedure is sequential and is only run one time. Have you ever trained a deep net over a distributed architecture? Please comment and share your experiences. In the next video, we'll take a look at the Torch library.